comes off the stage, we hear that, oh, they couldn't stay in their seats, they were so excited. They couldn't stop yelling questions because they were so excited. Well, stop that shit, all right? You stay in your seats so the people in the back can see, the people in the front can see, everybody can see. Put your phones on silent so you can hear these people talk up here, and you gotta stop yelling so we can answer the damn questions, and we're gonna continue this party. What do you think?
And no streaming.
And no live streaming, which I don't think that's a problem.
Bridge thing for a while, and you're there and you're going into labor and at the bottom of this bridge, and
And then Jason found her, but what was it like playing those scenes? Were you like, I want this over with, or were you like, into those?
No, I wanted to continue giving labor in the snow. And playing those scenes was amazing. In fact, I think I shot 6 shows that day. So we did everything that involved the bridge and the delivery and the baby all in one day. It might have been the most I'd ever shot in one day, but I appreciated it. It kept me focused and in character, and I made sure the set was, the air conditioning was on, so it's actually freezing, which it's never on when I'm on, unless Billy complains. He normally
I sweat.
But I had an emotional hangover afterwards.
You did?
For at least a week. It was
traumatic.
Traumatic, to say the least.
Like, and that's an example.
Working with me usually is.
It's traumatic.
This is true.
But are you guys able to, on that note, are you guys able to shut off, you know, you have these horrible emotional scenes and you go home? A lot of actors either shut it off or they can't. Billy,
it's like a hangover. It lingers.
Yeah.
Did you go home with baby?
No, and I get to go home with any baby. It was hard for me to shut off. I was kind of in that space for a week or so.
Billy, when you have heavy emotional scenes, can you cut it off when you go home, or are you still in that space when you leave the studio?
He's still in the space right now.
Still in the space right now.
It depends. I was filming dreams. We did a lot. She had to carry the show. It was pretty much we did the whole thing in one take. There's a baby. There's slippery ice. It was nuts. So yeah, it turned out really great. I'm proud of her. And I just had to catch.
That might have been the first compliment I'd ever received from Billy. Thanks, Billy.
And then on Friday, you guys saw Friday's episode, right? So Jason is like standing on the pressure plate after he saves Robin. And now he's going up to the roof with Curtis as they try to detonate this bomb or get to the bomb squad, if I'm understanding it right. Do you like playing Jason as Super Dude saving the world, or what's your, how do you feel about that character of Super Dude?
I didn't know he was going to come with a cape. It's fun. I think it's more fun to play like the, how do we get out of this conundrum more than da-da-da-da, you know, make it a little bit more believable.
But you like that part of the character.
It's fun, man. Yeah. I mean, yeah, we get to do some silly stuff. And you hit guys, they go down, they don't hit you back.
Roger, you know, everybody always, and a lot of people ask this question, so I want to ask you, you know, you're one of the preeminent actors in daytime. I think we can all agree that he is one of those guys that out here. You're very unique in your approach to the material and how you do it. And a lot of people always ask, are you staying true to the material or do you ad-lib a lot? I think that's a question people think. Is that true, partly true, not true?
I'm prepared for this question.
Okay.
It says no.
Who wrote that?
I did. It says no, never. I try not to... I think there's a sense of play in what we do and we should be having fun, so I try and embrace that. I don't believe in surprising an actor. You can't surprise a camera person because they won't get it. So if you can throw something in a rehearsal and it gets bought, then we'll do it.
You must hate me.
But I also think that like we try to make it look like what we're saying is something that we're thinking for the first time.
Right.
So it should appear spontaneous even if it is rehearsed.
There you go. Matt, you know, you're linked up in story with Vanola Hughes.
I did.
And Kimberly McCullough, who are now also really. What is it like working with these ladies? And do you feel anchored in now into the Port Charles canvas because of that, those relationships?
Yeah, no, I don't know what I feel. I feel like that I'm on TV with all these television, this, you know, they're royalty, these people to me. I'm, no, I shouldn't be sitting with the three of you up here, honestly. I'm like just a guy that likes to make people scream real loud, you know what I'm saying? I like to have good fun and...
What did he say?
I heard that too.
I need the Sabbath, man.
Hey, man, don't check it down that direction. Or two, actually. I don't know. Working with Vanola and Robin is definitely grounded me on the show and giving me like a place where I feel like I fit in somewhat, but no, I mean, I don't feel comfortable. still, if that's the question, yeah, I feel lucky to wake up and be a kid in a grown person's body playing make-believe. I mean, I think it's great. I don't think I'll ever be comfortable.
I think you shouldn't be comfortable.
Right,
it's a weird thing to do. There's a lot of people paying attention, and you owe them, you know, to be a little nervous. It's like you should be a little...
Right. But I like that, you know? Yeah. Like, I like to feel on edge. I feel like it just keeps you just alert.
We wear makeup for a living. And
yes, I know. And it's funny.
It's kind of hard to say, I had a bad day today. Yeah. What did you do? I saved the world and made out with her. But I didn't really like the color of my blush. I think it wasn't.
Kelly Monaco, now that Sam gave birth to a baby girl, and if you look into the future, do you think Emily will be, do you want her to be a light like Sam, or would you hope she's a different kind of gal?
Well, I hope she's nothing like Sam. Especially as a child. I hope she grows up to be just like her daddy.
God help us all. Gun shopping after this.
So do you
I hope she gets to grow up.
Yeah, but not in like 1 week.
What if her child?
No, I mean, I hope they don't kill her.
We'll come back, she'll be 25.
What if they start as the child and she's like 20?
Then I'm fucked.
You're lit. That would be that. Billy, you and Laura Wright have created the Jason Carley friendship, and you're the second, you know.
Well,
I mean, it started with Steve Bird. Yeah, I mean, it started with that, and you came in. How was it crafting that and that friendship? Because you're Jason. How is working with Laura to keep that on-screen relationship?
Well, a question for her. I'm the different Jason, but she was geared for it. It was like, wham, I'm going to give you a hug. And no, she's great, easy to work with, and a lot of fun, very welcoming. The whole process was easy compared to, I know a lot of recasts have a hard time, but people went out of their way to make sure that I fit in. I wasn't bullied. It was good.
You weren't bullied. They bullied.
They put me in the locker at work. No, it's all good.
I think everyone, you know, Roger, when you did the nurse's ball last year with little Jake and you sang the time changer, was that not great? Time changes everything.
It's so
atypical. It was so sweet.
He's a sweet kid.
Well, what about you? You were singing up there and playing the...
I went like this.
But was that...
I had an egg. That was like...
Like a lot of
maraca. Yeah. 4 years at the Manhattan School of Music and I got a maraca.
But the fans love it.
Watch what you wish for. There will be another nurse's ball in a couple of months.
I gotta say, no. I, in all seriousness, that's terrifying for me. So I think.
Okay, he's backtracking.
No, I'm not. I think you're supposed to. It's supposed to. You're supposed to do things that are kind of frightening.
So like stripping for the.
The maraca was not terrifying. That kid is awesome. He's a great kid. It's a good story. I thought it was like it wasn't like. It wasn't arbitrary. Like it was story motivated. It told a story. It was cool. He sang really sweet. I don't know. It's kind of a boring answer. I'm sorry.
No, it's a good answer. So we saw Griffin strapped to a chair, shirtless, this week. And you were working with Tanya Walker. And then you all of a sudden became Duke, like faux Duke.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
yeah, the Duke wasn't even there. Ian wasn't even there. It was actually me playing him. I'm that good of an actor. I'm such a chameleon. I can change bodies and generation types, no problem.
So when you take those scenes, did you guys not have, did you remain serious? That was, or how did you get through those scenes?
We tried to remain serious until I tried to do an accent like Ian. It sounded like such a complete asshole that it just loosened the whole day up real quick. Because they were like, Frank was like, can you do an accent? I'm like, yeah, sure.
Pirate accent.
Like not 10 seconds later, the response from like the entire crew was like, "You have a really good act. Just your normal accent's good. You should do that one." I was like, "Oh, I got you, guys. I'll just be the Matt up here, better than the Ian." I don't know what your question was because I went on that tangent.
It was funny to do it.
I went on that tangent right over you. As I'm gonna do it probably 20 more times than I do.
Yeah.
What was it?
Was it fun to do?
Yeah, it was
did you have? Did you laugh?
I got to
did
meet you the her? Guy. That's okay. My dad. It's cool. It was awesome. He's an icon. Fanola tells me every day, this sweet Ian, you should be more like him. And I'm like, all right, I'll work my hardest to be like sweet Ian.
I know, Emmer.
So do you guys like Franco and Liz together? Do you like Franco and Liz together?
I think it's a really sweet story.
And how's working with Rebecca?
She's amazing.
Yeah.
She's wonderful to work with.
Yeah. And for you to play this now, you feel it shows a different side of Franco in the story?
You know what? One of the things I like about the story is that I think that these are two people that really just enjoy being around one another, and it seems to be that all the other parts of their lives are stacked against them and kind of working against them being together, and so that seems very kind of, I don't know, I think it's a good story. It seems like there are probably situations like that in people's lives, where, like, outside influences are a problem. Another boring answer. She's great. She's
yeah. Cool. Kelly, so when you first met Billy...
Oh, shit.
Like, what did you think? What was your first impression of him?
Apparently, I don't remember the first time I met him. I was in Vegas.
A great gold dress you had on.
I think you may have won that year. Did you?
I don't know. I won something.
Not me. Billy's awesome. I could not have asked for a better on-screen co-star. I'm super excited every single day I get to go in and work with him, even when he's grumpy.
Is that a lot? Or?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have fun together.
What?
He's a jokester, so he lightens up the...
A giant child.
You're giant compared to me. Yes, he is a giant child. He's like a 5-year-old.
It's supposed to be fun, you know? You're going out playing make-believe. It's, you know, it can't be too serious.
What did you think of Kelly, Billy?
Jesus, look at her.
I know. It's so sad.
Yeah, I was like, damn.
Yeah.
This is going to be tough. So tough.
No, she's...
But then you acted with her, and then...
Kelly's...
Billy, when's the first time you met me?
We were gambling on horses.
That's right.
At the Breeders' Cup. That's a different story. Kelly's super, super, super sweet. A lot of fun to work with. She puts so much effort into it that sometimes I have to check myself and be like, maybe I need to work a little harder. But she cares immensely about the show and the fans and to put out a good product. So that's always fun to show up to work. We all have days where you go to work, you're like, I don't feel like working today, but you know, Kelly's usually like, hey, let's have some coffee and let's get to work. So, start smiling. Yeah. A lot of fun.
Yeah.
A lot of fun.
Roger, when you put Tom Baker in that cage...
Yes.
And then you're talking to him in the... I mean, that was really... Remember talking to him in the cage and he was kind of... That was... Do you remember doing that?
Vaguely.
That was such a great scene. So how did you kind of, what did you think of the process of that scene, and what did you think of the writing of it and then doing that?
I thought the writing was great. I think it's a bold, weird story. There's a man in a dog cage. It's fun to start. And,
Sometimes you pick up these scripts and you're like, I gotta do what?
Well, that was a quick
that actually was one of the days where I was not like super prepared, and I did kind of walk on the set and go, what is that? And why is there a dog?
Get in your cage.
And I thought that actor was amazing. I don't, you know, he was certainly committed. Like, he was ready. He's one of, like, I didn't answer the question about emotional regulation after the scene. I regulate pretty quickly, I feel. Like, it's really clearly make-believe for me. And then when make-believe time is over, then this guy lived in that world for like a couple of weeks. Like people were like, how's it to work with that guy? I had a great time with him though. Really, really.
It was great. And on that, did all of you have a moment where you've looked at a script, you've gotten the script, you open it, and your mouth drops, and you're like, oh my God, I have to do that? If you had that, what could you say?
Every goddamn day.
I have the experience
they
sometimes.
They top it? How did they top it?
Where you don't read, like you just kind of read it cursorily and you read the dialogue and you get the kind of brush, big strokes of what the day's going to be like. And then you don't read the big print and then you get there and you realize like, oh, so, you know, Franco's doing his taxes. So, da 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 da. And then you get there and you actually are with what's in the big print and it says like he answers the door in a towel. That's always, like those are the surprises for me. Like what they that's it.
Billy, have yeah. you had to pad open the script and you're like, what? What?
I mean sometimes. I writing a show like this has to be so hard. We put up so much material. There's decades and decades of backstory, there's so many characters, that job is daunting to say the least. So there's gonna be some times where you're like, huh, you wrote that and submitted it, and they said yes. And I've gotta do it in my underwear. Maybe I should have skipped that in an Albertus.
Matt, have you had that moment where you've looked at
Look at his skinny ass. He's never had the cheeseburger. No. I used to box with this guy. He comes out like he's got abs on his ears.
My contract when I signed on for GH said strictly no in and out until you complete your work on the show at the end of your
schedule. Well,
I mean,
I don't think.
What about the reveal? What about the reveal? What about the reveal when we realized he was a priest? It wasn't over Carlos when you're doing last rites?
That's acting.
Yeah.
Trust me. I've known this guy for a long time,
right? It was a bit of a stretch, the priest.
A lot of a stretch. I'm surprised I haven't caught on fucking fire.
Yeah, this is. How should I say this? They don't let my type in those establishments, you know? They
absolutely.
They don't have me there at those places often.
Exercise you out, actually.
Yeah. Don't come past the stairs, or the bottom stair, actually. But I don't think any of my material's been weird. Like, the most recent script, when I read the thing about being strapped to a table shirtless and she was pouring Japanese tea down my throat, in which I was then gonna become my father and lose my soul, that's normal.
That's a good story.
It's not that strange.
Are you still doing mushrooms?
I just, yeah. In preparation, I'm glad you brought that up. In preparation for the role, there was, I often get this question, how do you get into that moment for the role? And it's great that you segued us into this. Magic mushrooms, guys. If you're ever gonna have your soul removed on television, a great way to prepare for that is experimenting with the
inside
Earth's
the actor.
Plant.
This is the technique, inside the technique.
Yeah, I'm a dedicated actor. What do you want from me, Michael? I work hard at this craft, mushrooms and all.
And that's why we stopped hanging out.
Now I just sit in my room and wonder why the walls are melting.
So I have some questions that you guys sent in or gave us earlier. I'll ask a few of them. First of all, this is Tamara Reed, 19, for Billy Miller. Hey.
What's up?
What's up? Since taking over the role of Jason, she asked, what has been your favorite storyline so far?
Favorite storyline so far. I think, Jason. you stay around, I'm gonna need you. You're gonna laugh at that, goddamn. Today's gonna go easy. Do what? Memorization? I got scrambled eggs over here, man. The guy's had how many brain surgeries and brain incidents, and I'm surprised I'm not walking around going, I'm gonna see my baseball. No,
So,
I think actually, you know, Jason finding Kelly, Sam, they're the same damn person.
We are in fact the same person.
Yeah, right. Like, they're like my grandmother, Sam, Kelly, whatever her name is. That was, you know, that kind of like brought me back into actually this is a character I'm playing, so. Kind of trying to figure it out, and everybody trying to figure out exactly what I was doing, because none of us knew for about a year and a half. Yeah. Solidified. All right, Billy's playing Jason.
Leanne, F38, has a question for Kelly Monaco. Was it fun giving birth in skinny jeans and boots? Is that fun?
See, what happened was... a very good explanation for this.
Okay.
I do. Jason had his switchblade on him, and he cut a hole.
We actually said this.
No, because I argued the point too. I said, take my boots off, take my pants off. Like.
Yeah, and this is the first time anybody said no.
Yes, we actually said no.
I didn't say no.
I said, justify it then. And they said, well, Jason took out his switchblade and he cut open where he needed to cut open. And he had to cut the cord. So just imagine, it was so cold, I had to keep my boots on and pants on, and I just hit a hole.
I mean, the kid was small.
It was a small kid. I mean, you were down there, what that looked like.
Awesome.
For Roger. Roger, when will Franco be the crazy Franco like before? Do you want him to be the crazy Franco like before? Yeah. Is that a no? I hear no love.
I have no idea. That's another boring answer.
I guess I want to know, would you like him to be that crazy?
Oh, yeah, I think, yeah, you know, the thing about playing nice guy is you can move into, like, too nice really quickly, and then it's awful and boring. But with a bad guy, you can always go a little further, and so as an actor, I think it's always fun to play the bad guy. It's always fun, man. It's fun.
The entire, this is for Sarah, for the entire panel. Are cast members able to schedule other projects for themselves since the show tapes all year round? I know you're doing
massages, definitely.
This was great, Donovan, right?
Yeah. I get lucky enough. The schedule here is lucky. Yeah. I've been lucky. You talk about the character? You're confusing me, honey. I don't know what's going on. All I see is a halo and
lucky.
Yeah, the schedule here, because we have a lot of dark days on this show, so it's easier to try to like thread the needle and try to get other work, and I've been lucky so far. We'll see what happens, but yeah, that's my boring answer.
Roger?
What? Oh, I got to answer too?
Oh, no, I'm just saying hi.
I mean, I think there's a lot of moving parts. There's sets that are up for certain times and sets that go down, and it's hard. Like, you have to give them a lot of notice if you're going to sneak out the door for a little bit. And there's a lot of, you know...
Frank has been great about that sort of thing, so... We're all trying to work and do things.
And Matt, you're
doing
Criminal Minds Beyond Borders.
Yeah, mushrooms.
Mushrooms on Criminal Minds Beyond Borders.
Yeah, Criminal Minds Beyond Borders. Like Billy said, it's very lucky to get work, to be an actor, all these things, and to have any opportunity to do more work, you know, it's just all luck, man. I don't know, I feel lucky watching Criminal Minds Beyond Borders, and I'll be on there, but it's, you know, threading the needle. You know, you're shooting a lot on this show, and if you can fit it in, I mean, there's going to be plenty of times where you probably can't, you know, audition or have a meeting or take the job because you're working on your home job. You know, you got to support
You know, your home foundation, man. That's gotta have a strong foundation, or you're gonna crumble, right?
Yeah. Woo!
So this is from Annette Perry, B23. For
it's like bingo.
It's like bingo. B23. Roger Howarth. Roger.
Hi.
What storyline would you still like to have for your character? Is there a storyline you'd love to do that you haven't had the opportunity to do? With Franco.
With Franco.
Something you'd like to explore.
Yeah, I'm not great at this. I'm learning that. I'm much better when people tell me what to say. I'm going to answer this just off the top of my head because I saw an actor working the other day that I was working and I God, why do people put up with me? Risa plays Amy.
Yes.
And I just thought she did something so sweet and smart and I was like, oh, what a cool actor. I thought she was neat. So, I don't know, something with Amy.
That's interesting.
But you know what? I think it's a pretty great cast. I mean, we're really lucky. So I think, I think that Franco with different people is always different. So pretty much anyone that's, yeah, I'm up for whatever.
Your game.
Yeah.
So Connie, L41, for Billy Miller, will Jason and Curtis be in the PI business together? That seems like an answer.
You gotta ask my wife. Then no, goddammit.
Huh.
See you. No,
and I do have my own company. Would you go and work for someone else?
If you, I mean, why try to break up a happy home?
We both get handcuffs.
See, what had happened was, we must forgive my friend over here. Working with Donnell's been a lot of fun. I think the dynamic works. We get to play around a little bit. And that's something I've missed in this role. There's not a lot of time for comedy, which I think in a melodrama, you gotta try to get that whenever you can. And this sort of duo, if you will, is providing that. So, I don't know, it seems fun. I laugh.
I think it's good.
I think we're fun.
I think it's good, right? You like that? Kelly Monaco, this is from Connie in L41 as well. She asks, who is the most craziest villain you've ever worked with?
Okay. No. He's not crazy.
That's just sad.
The craziest villain I ever worked with would probably have to be Manny. He was scary. He scared me. And I don't know if I worked with him, but Tom Baker, is that who we were just talking about?
Yeah.
He fucking scared the shit out of me.
So
like, I was afraid, I was afraid to go home by myself. I had to take like a couple different ways, so, and like look behind my mirror. I'm not joking.
Those were fun phone calls.
Because he's a good actor. he creeped me out.
It was so creepy, but you said he was great to work with too.
Right, right. I mean, yeah,
he didn't follow me home. So.
All right, do you guys have some questions out there? I'll come into the audience and we will ask these guys. Remember, not a group question since we want to get to a lot of people. All right, here we go. Let's see if anybody has a question.
Dude, you are not the father.
Monaco.
Oh, there you guys are.
What's your name?
Kathy.
How long have you been watching, G?
From 1962.
Alright, here's a question for Kelly.
Hi, Kathy.
If you could pick one castmate on GH, who would you pick to be on Dancing with the Stars?
I a 1,000,000% hands down say Billy Miller. You guys have no idea. You have no idea how well he can dance. He doesn't want to do it. And considering he doesn't want to do it, I know Chad really wants to do it, so I'd like to see him on there. But I'd really like to see Billy in some sequins, rhinestones, and glitter.
I just want to see me in sequins.
and a spray tan. Seriously, he can dance.
Thank you.
He can dance.
Let's see it.
Who's your question for? Okay, we have a question for Billy Miller.
Hey, Billy, I read you're going to be on one of my favorite shows. Can you tell us a little bit something about your character on Ray Donovan?
He just talked about it, so.
Not just yet. I can't really talk about that just yet.
Good guy or bad guy?
I mean, is there a good guy or bad guy on Ray Donovan?
Sorry. That was like, wah, wah, wah. Thanks for coming, Billy. You're a jerk.
Okay, back here. Your name?
Eric.
Hey, Eric. Your question is from Roger Howard.
Hi, Roger.
Hi, Eric.
I've been watching you since 1993.
Thank you so much.
I've recorded, my mom is, I went to school. My mom has recorded every episode of One Life to Live. I watched you, I'm going through classes, I'm thinking about the storyline and what you're gonna do. I'm really nervous right now, so.
Yeah, me too.
I wanna say one thing. I wanna say I really appreciate the last scene that you did with Kristen Alderson, star Annie, on General Hospital.
Yeah.
That last scene, it was really emotional for me, and
thank
I
you
cried
so
actually during the episode, and actually I noticed you did too, and I really appreciated that. And my question for you was, when you did the DID storyline on One Life to Live in 1998.
Oh yes.
And you came up with the character of Rob.
There were like three or four people in.
There was like Tom.
So for those of you that didn't see.
My question is, how did you get inspired to do that character?
Well, the inspiration is always direct deposit. And no, listen, dude, thank you so much for all of your warmth and support and for watching for all that time. I really appreciate it. And thank you all for coming. I didn't realize there were so many of you. We couldn't see you until recently. You kind of said a couple of different things. I get to now publicly say how much I appreciate what we do for a lot of reasons, but I think it's really sweet that people watch with their loved ones. In today's, what we're doing now by ourselves, like it's always really cool for me to hear people say, I watch with my mom, I watch with my kids, I watch with, you know, I think that's really, really kind of awesome. I don't remember Roy, I think Roy, there were a couple of guys, like one was Italian, one was a woman, and that was really fun. That was motivated by, there was another character on the show named Erica played Vicky, and Vicky had like Vicky and Nikki, so they just kind of, yeah, she was amazing. It was a really, and that particular scene that you were so generous and kind about, we got that morning, those were like pink pages, like Ron just kind of threw that together, because he thought that the fans would really appreciate her having a chance to kind of say goodbye to somebody that, you know, I worked with that little girl, she was this big when I met her, and she walked out the door, you know, 20 something years later.
So such an amazing, it's
like that Linklater movie, boy, did you watch this kid grow up on TV.
We have a question for Kelly.
Hi Kelly, Megan.
Hi again.
I just wanted to know, do you like to watch yourself after you acted, like, see yourself on TV? No?
No, and I think it's really important for me not to, because I'm my worst. I hate myself more than anyone does. So I will tear myself apart, and maybe things that are working for the character and that you, the audience, like, I'll hate and I'll try and fix and then totally destroy the character. So I try not to watch myself.
Do you hug?
What? No, I do. I'm really insecure when it comes to that. I don't like the sound of my voice. Everything looks bad. No, I can't. Yeah. I couldn't even with Dancing with the Stars. I never watched one. one of my dances until I was making fun of myself like
a
couple months ago. I couldn't watch anything. Thank you.
Question over here for Kelly Monaco.
Hi Kelly, I'm Lisa.
Been watching for over 40 years.
Oh, over there, hi.
I know a lot of fans were upset when Port Charles ended. You were great on Port Charles. And right after you got General Hospital. Did you know at the time that you were gonna be cast on General Hospital?
Within the, I think I got the call that the show was being canceled, and I think I cried for like 5 seconds. No, it's pretty fucked up. I fortunately had a call moments later with an option to pretty much kind of take my pick. And I thought General Hospital was the best show on daytime. So I begged Brian Franz, who was our the head of ABC Daytime at the time, to create a character for me. And even though I don't think Chuck and Guza really liked that too much, lo and behold, Sam was created. So I'm very, very, very grateful to have had the opportunity.
Did we lose him?
Right here. Oh, there he is. Stand up. I'm here.
What's your question?
My name is Susan.
Susan.
Question is for Roger.
Roger.
Hi. So I know One Life to Live filmed in New York, right? And now you're obviously filming here. What was that like for you to make that move in your personal life from there to here?
I still live in New York City. It's in New York.
Oh.
Because New York's awesome. Question from Matt.
Hey.
Hi Matt, how are you?
I'm doing awesome. How are you, front row person? You're feeling damn good about that seat position, aren't you?
Hi, yes, I'm in A1, right fucking middle. This is my... Nobody's standing in front of me today. I'm gonna see everything I want to see. Sorry, question.
I saw you on How to Get Away with Murder initially, and then of course you have your other primetime soap shows, and then of course daytime. How do you feel is the difference? Because even How to Get Away with Murder was very intense, and your taping here is very intense as they go really fast. So how do you feel, what's the difference between primetime and here? Like, what do you feel?
Daytime actors are working significantly harder than primetime actors. And I will eat those words from 1,000 primetime actors, will shove those words down my throat and explain to me differently. And then I'll say, here's
3/8 of a page.
Yeah,
I'll invite them to our set and see if they can
do it. Yeah, I'll say, here's the 65 pages that any of these actors do on a daily basis. And I'm in my room sweating, trying to get my 30, 40 pages done. And we shoot, what, 180 to 100 on a day is a page count there? We're like on a primetime show, you're shooting 8, 10 pages is a huge day on primetime. So I just think daytime, they're busting their ass, man. It's difficult and it's hard, and you're grasping onto material in a short amount of time and trying to make it make sense. It's very difficult. I think daytime, busting their ass.
All right, over here, we have a question for Kelly Monaco from Nicholas.
Hi, Kelly. It's Spare. Hi Kelly, it's been so long.
Hi sweet boy, how
Nicholas.
Are you? It's good to see you, I'm glad you can make it out today.
Yeah, for sure. My question is, what was your favorite storyline for Sam as of 2016?
As of 2016, that would have been last year?
yes,
ahem.
It would have been last year.
Ahem. I guess her rediscovering her dead husband. I mean, getting pregnant, I feel like them finally having their baby girl.
Yeah.
That's my favorite. It certainly wasn't reliving the...
The dark age. Great in the dark age scenes.
I did like the dark age scenes.
Oh,
though.
She did an awesome... You should watch in public.
You looked good in
public
age.
All right, Kelly, we have a question.
Yes. Okay. So, kill, marry, F.
Out of these three?
Maurice, or Sunny, Jason, Franco.
Okay, wait,
what's
wait.
What's going on?
Okay.
What is going on?
I will... Oh, man. Wait, how do you put this in regular terms?
Yes.
Kill, marry, what? Yeah, yeah.
I'm shocked!
Aren't they all kind of like universal?
Well, I already had sex with two of them, so we might as well just kill them and I'll marry Franco.
Good luck, buddy.
We have a question for Raj.
Hi, Roger. I'm Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
How has being a soap opera actor and all of the fame that comes with it impacted your personal life and your ability to actually go out in public? Has that affected you in any way?
No. No, you know, that I Phil Carey played Asa on One Last Time. He was a difficult human being. But he used to joke about being in the witness protection program. Because we have, like, first of all, I just like to say actor instead of daytime actor. Because I know that sounds kind of snotty, but we're actors. And so I don't think it's impacted negatively in my life at all. There have been some really nice moments where, and in I don't know if you guys are, you can't all be from Los Angeles, but yeah, in New York, you know, we talk to each other and say hello. It's awesome. Like we're forced to deal with one another because we're all really close. And so every day I'm in New York City, someone will say something nice to me. So that's the only way it's impacted me. I get to meet nice people and they say nice things to me. It's pretty cool.
So what would you say in a broad stroke to the fans that they could look forward to coming up with Jason? Like a tease, not too far in the future, but you know where we are, obviously, he's going up to the room.
Man, there's a lot going on.
Does it get more exciting?
I hope so. I'm not quite sure where we left off, but those scenes were a lot of fun.
You're on the pressure plate.
Those scenes were a lot of fun. Came right after the whole baby stuff, and like Kelly said, we shot a lot that week, and then it was cool to have a little bit of comic relief while you're standing on a bomb. You know, as you do.
Bombs are hysterical.
They are. They're kind of funny.
Bombs are funny.
Not really at all. But I think that's going to be a good couple of shows coming up this week, and then you know we have a whole baby thing to deal with, like that changes your life. So.
And Sam, I'm Mr. Kelly, I'm Mr. Sam's gonna be worried sick because Jason and there's his baby and he's in danger. And
did you not hear the last question?
I heard she was
kill us both and raise Franco. She's
so Franco, worried. She wants you.
Sam recovers quickly from
hemorrhaging,
yes. No stitches, running around quickly, no high heels. I made sure they put me in flats.
No high heels for a minute?
Yeah, no high heels for a second. Yeah.
Look mighty good in them jeans.
Does the fact that he's saving the day, will that make her think twice, like, oh my God, I don't want him to be in this dangerous business now that we have another child?
No, she tries to run in after him. She tries to pass her child off as somebody else. Here, take her! I'm going after Jason! And I was like, would she do that? No. But it was Epiphany. We can trust her.
So, Roger, what can we look forward to from Franco?
Oh, I don't know.
He stops me from going into burning mode.
Oh, is that what happens? Oh, that was awesome. We shot that? We had some fun
stuff.
I was taking Matt's mushrooms.
Mushroom.
No, I'm trying to think of a way to answer without like
giving it away.
Actually,
right.
You know?
Right.
I think that Franco and Elizabeth get to know each other in different circumstances. That's it.
Okay, Matt. What's happening?
Griffin will very soon be pregnant with Franco's baby.
He has a lot of play.
Because he was in the laboratory with Dr. Finn, and Dr. Finn gave him some crazy-ass mushrooms that weren't in his general diet. And he thought long-haired Franco was the loveliest lady in the hospital tonight. And he's into some hardcore stuff. He saw that dog cage and he saw Franco, and one thing led to the next. And tune in next week, it's gonna be real good.
Brought the iguana along.
Again, this is why we stopped hanging out.
I do want to say to close this out, the fans have been so amazing. They've supported Billy and Kelly and Roger and Matt throughout the career. And your support has meant so much to them, I'm sure. Do you have a few words you could say to the fans for how they've continued to hang in with you and always been there by your side, and they've been so loyal? I'm kind of saying it for you.
There's no better fan than soap fans. Like Matt said, we go to work. Where it's a grueling pace, and it's great. It's rewarding for you guys to continue to support us and come to see us and watch the show. It means a lot. And like Roger said, it's a family sort of event. You know, it's that community is pretty special.
Kelly, do you have a few words?
I mean, it's I think universal. Thank you all so much for your dedication and your hard work to actually press Devo or go home every day. Seriously, to think about our show, and I hope that we're able to take you out of what might be going on in your personal life and put a smile on your face. That's
Roger, do you have anything to talk to
about? I'm amazed. You guys, thank you so much.
Matt,
I've never been so welcomely groped into a fan base my whole life. Thank you for all the chest and app feels yesterday, and I get to be up here because you guys do your thing and you guys tune in, so I just thank you for letting me be part of it.
And thank you guys so much. Thank you.
Goes. Welcome to Laura's World. I'll see you guys.